Ernie Ball Music Man Silhouette Special. And what's special about this is that the frets have had the shit kicked out of them, and then somebody decided they were going to fret dress, only they didn't do it. They just ground all the tops off the frets. So, we're going to fix it. There's still a lot of fret material there. We're going to put proper crowns back on these, and it's going to play great. Wait and see. Bolt-on neck fret work, like I'm going to do, requires that the neck get taken off the guitar. Stand by for that one. This is a cool example of what happens when you burn through the thin skin lacquer, then don't clean it or whatever they use. But see, now that green, that's mildew in the fretboard. It's growing in the wood. Unless the person, you know, likes to eat green jelly beans and play guitar. That's what that is. I tried to clean a couple of the fret spaces. See what I can do. Most of it's going to come off. It'll all get cleaned up. Look much better, but I still have to get the neck off the thing. So let's do this. You always love this sort of information. It's about 10, 11 years old. Sweet. Let's flip it over. And before I get into doing any fretwork, I'm going to try and clean up the fretboard first. That's just shitty looking. I should get rid of a lot of the green. Painted the frets blue. Get the leveling device out. Oh, also making sure the neck is as perfectly straight as we could possibly get it. Using your eye, your laser, your straight edge, whatever you feel you need to make the neck straight. Not the fret straight, the neck straight. We're going to... So a notch straight edge is a bit of an advantage, I guess, if you want to go at it that way. But I'm looking at this. Guitar's over a decade old. The neck is straight as... Oh yeah, truss rod is just barely engaged. Lots of frets left. Let's dress them perfect again. The dicey areas where the last guy like totally shaved the tops off everything. I'm stuck with what he's left as my lowest denominator. We'll be okay. This will be fine once we crown it up and polish it. That's about as close as I can get it. Screw you, YouTube. People love music. It's crowned. Nice stuff. These diamond guys make pretty fast work of this. Important to keep the file from I don't know why I never felt it before. I don't know why I waited so long to be sure. Okay, so I finished having my gay singing fit. Oh, did I say gay? Sorry. Singing fit. was just somewhat gay. Tape this up. We're going the old flapper method. So sometimes I just like to go at it and polish each fret individually, and that's how I showed Camille. Just work your way along, do them all. This is the other method. I got this flexible gizmo here, which is for sanding. Imagine that. And we wrap some, I'm at 400 grit here. And we don't want to do this because that would take the crowns off the top that I just put in. So that's sort of why the flapping motion. And I'll work through all the grits. What's that remind you of? Okay. I'll let you know when I get all the sanding stuff done. And then we'll go from there. That's some very nice frets. Let's find the body and put it back together. I'd really like to clean out some of that. Clean up that mildew a little more. We'll see what happens. The neck is reattached. Somebody said I sounded drunk. Yeah, I wish. No, I had a bunch of teeth taken out, which sort of makes me talk fucked up. And I also took a bunch of painkillers because they took my teeth out. So to hell with y'all. So that's it. Fret dressing's done. We got as much of the green stuff off as I dare remove. Gonna string it up. Had a couple questions. Oh, let's get the lighting factor back to there we go. About adjusting the nut after you do the fret dressing. Well, the nut wears as well as the frets. So in a lot of cases, there's really not much to do. It's within tolerance. I always check it, but like I said, the nut wears as at the same time as the frets get dented, as do all the parts on the guitar wear. I'm bunged about this stuff here because the spray thing doesn't work. Okay, it's like, it ain't me, I've jerked it off, it's like, okay, sprayed, and then, gooch, 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 see? Now, what do I do? What do I get? Okay. They tried to give me one of those warranty excuses. Well, it may be your operator error, like you didn't know how to push a spray bottle. I'm making fun now. The product does a nice job. Just the spray can sucks. Ah, I got cut on that. All right, strings. Well, it all checks out. I sort of tweaked it to Telestrat numbers. Really didn't have to do much. A little truss rod adjustment. Nothing to tweak on the nut as far as the nut action goes. And as I said before, guys questioned me about, well, what about that? Well, this is wearing at the same time as the frets, so everything's wearing, and it's all within tolerance and within what you can play. Some guys can play a straight arrow of a board with nails on it and some strings. The radius was all fine, wasn't all freaked out. Oh, this is screwed up. I gotta, I'll do a little bit of an end video as to how to, oh, what the hell happened to my camera, as to what to do there. I gotta go make a pizza, then I'm gonna make some more video, and then I'm gonna edit the video, cut the eye pokers off, and let the guy know I'm finished with his guitar, and his frets are just rude. Nice. Shitty about that green stuff, but maybe his skin will be blue and it'll counteract it. Oh, it's a tiny little blobule. Come on. Don't be a bitch with me. A tiny little blobule of acrylic model cement. Just enough to keep it from moving, but still not too much to take it off someday if you needed to pop it off. Pop it off, pop it off. That's all I'm doing for this. Oh, cutting the strings later. Cheers, folks. Music Man Silhouette Special. Or something like that. Nice new shiny frets.